hold that.
Christ, this is spooky.
What's that?
Grim sticking wires in your head, man.
I just need to sync the encryption signature between his subdermals and Fort Meade.
Don't like that.
I know. It's for after we land. You better hurry up, Grim. We touch down in Georgia in 15.
I'm already done. Lambert? Hey, Irving, do you read me?
Tell her I read her.
He reads you.
Good. You ready to get to work?
I'd feel better if I knew what was going on.
You know what you need to. The CIA lost a mole inside Georgian President Kombane Nikoladze's cabinet. Her name is Alice Madison. They sent in Agent William Robert Blaustein to find her and lost him, too.
Are we working with the CIA's cooperation?
Blaustein is outfitted with subdermals just like yours. That'll be your best lead to find him.
You didn't answer my question.
We'll tell you what you need to know. You're not out there alone, Fisher. Through me, you're attached to a dozen of the best NSA minds we have. There are political complexities with Georgia you'd need a week to understand.
I've just about memorized the speech, Lambert.
Well, start believing it. This is Third Echelon's maiden voyage, and we need it to go smooth as butter. You're about to touch down in Georgia. Get ready.
Tbilisi Old Town, Tbilisi, Georgia, October 16, 2004, 20:01 hours. Locate CIA agents Blaustein and Madison. Agent Allison Madison worked covertly in the Georgian political arena for 2 years, securing a role in President Nikoladze's cabinet after his coup d'etat. Damn, my French sucks. After his coup d'etat. She vanished on the October 3rd. On October 7th, Special Agent Robert Blaustein was sent in to find her. He vanished on October 11th. Well, that's the briefing for you guys.
Fisher, the sun's down. Time to go to work. Finding Agent Blaustein's our first priority. We're to locate him through a local NSA contact.
I'm on my way.
And stay off the streets. There's a heavy cop presence in this town. We don't have Washington's backing if this turns into an incident. Details on your offset.
Nice. So greetings, fellow Earthlings. And this is the second video of Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. My favorite franchise, as I've told you guys before. And as we can see right here, the situation is quite delicate. I don't think we need more of an introduction than that. But if we do, well, it would be good to have one, I guess. Not that I'm getting one. Okay, that's the highest I can go. Damn. I completely forgot how to play this level, to be honest. I don't remember much of it. So what can we do here? Do I shoot out the light? Well, not that I typically need to right now. I mean, that guy's looking up over there. Might as well just quick save right now.
What was that?
Yeah, that was not ideal. That was literally not ideal. But oh well, whatever works. I guess it wasn't that much of an issue, anyway. Yeah, boy, open it slowly, just like that. One of the things that I don't particularly like about this game is how everything is so slow. But damn, this third-party lighting is really helping out. Here's the pipe that we need to take. Just look at how much more beautiful it makes the game. I mean, it wouldn't be this beautiful with the default processor. And this is the part where it gets basic.
Gergenidze is inside there.
Why would I tell you what you already know? I have to hurry. Grim's daughter's comparing a Dark Star drone sonar to the warehouse blueprints. She'll be guiding you through.
Sam, Grim's daughter here. I say jump. Don't ask how high, just do it. You should get through this fine. There's a room directly across the hall. Go there now.
Okay.
Sam, sorry about that. Get back into the hall and go to the stairwell at the far end. Make it fast. You've only got a few seconds.
And yeah, this section of the game is sort of a... Well, sort of. I don't know what it is. It's just something. And yeah, you just need to jump up and grab this pipe right here. Everything's literally crumbling. Oh, come on, move.
Jesus, but that was close.
No
Take
shit.
Take a left just ahead and cut through the room. You'll find a stairwell on the opposite corner. Take it to the top floor.
A stairwell on the opposite corner, huh? And did I get her? No, I didn't. Not yet.
The contact is in this room. Oh. Let's hope to God he's still alive.
Come on.
You're gonna need to.
Yeah.
I'm in the sale. I'm gonna get you out of here.
Don't bother. I'm as good as dead. You're looking for Blaustein and Madison.
Yeah.
Madison was deep into Nikoladze's cabinet. She was onto something big. Blaustein must have figured it out.
How do I find him?
Blaustein's black box, the tracking relay for his subdermals. It's stashed in his safe house just east of Morevi Square.
Lambert, do we have resources to evac this guy?
I said don't bother. Whatever Madison found, it's big. She kept saying proof would mean war. I think Nikoladze wanted... Oh.
Gerganidze checked out.
Leave the corpse for the fire. It'd be best to explain to his family.
You've got a safe exit on the west side of the room. Take it.
Let's explain to his family, apparently. So right now what we need
There's
to do is...
There's too much smoke. Shoot out the skylights.
Yeah, pretty much. And that's it. That's all you have to do. Now, take the lockpicks and pick this door. Oh wait, this door opens. This one doesn't.
That was pretty tight. You still breathing?
Doing my best.
Good. Blaustein's black box is your next objective. If he's running standard agency tradecraft, you'll find the box behind a fake bookshelf or wall panel.
So you basically need to remember that you will find the box there. And yeah, this is practically what I meant when I said said that this game was pretty clunky. It doesn't exactly...
Good gringo on. Because those are my orders. I speak to Vyacheslav Gringo or nobody. As Gringo, sir, this is Keteman. We finished searching the American's apartment. There is nothing else there. If five more bugs, two cameras, and some electronics we can't ID. They are already on their way to the ministry. Of course. Thank you, sir.
Now, what we need to do is we just need to wait for a bit. Because I believe there will be a guy coming through there. I'm not sure. Seems to be no one. Right now we can risk it. I mean, let's just quicksave. And let's just hug this wall here. So that we don't discover, risk discovery. And all we need to do is keep moving forward. The first time around I played this game, it was... These sections just seem so dark. Yeah, let that guy pass. And now, let's just quick save.
Did you check under the bed?
Yes, I'm telling you. There's nothing else here.
Gringo says to do a final sweep and then wrap it up.
We've checked everywhere. The place is clean.
Don't cross Gringo. Yeah.
And just get the data signal from the computer there. Rush to the end of the place. What you're looking for is right behind this thing here. Just use the computer. You'll get a data signal. And it will give you a note with the balcony key, 091772.
Dang!
What's the news?
Blaustein's heart stopped beating 43 hours ago.
Any reason the CIA wouldn't know about this?
Nope.
Nice of them to share.
The subdermal went offline 6 hours after he died. Last active position was in a police station a few blocks away. Check your opsat.
That's it for this. That is a smooth extraction, I guess. Now, just let me just take a moment to read all the data that I have. Damn, that is a lot. Oh yeah, data 6. From David Tannehill to Dr. William Robert Blaustein, forward, drop dead. Really? Wow, that's a nice subject line to have, you know? A nice introduction for email. BB, oh wow. So romantic. Got the following from my man Gerganidze. I've got the envelope, thank you very much. I'll have the police station information in a dead drop. Okay, behind the bushes in Morevi Square. I'm sure he'll be there. Tom's a trustworthy type. If I can safely make the drop, I'll leave you a toy or two. Walk softly. And that's that. About this data stick. From William Robert Blaustein to Madison again. Mr. Sutton, I think we can stop dancing around the words Agent Madison instead. Our only real question now is why, or more importantly, why Nikoladze thought he could hide it from us. Your theory about her disappearance is a way to keep secret the connection between Georgian politics and the Russian mafia works, but it's too easy. It wouldn't justify murdering a US agent, and Nikoladze knows how dirty he is. I think I'm being followed, though it's hard to separate paranoia from reason in this part of the world. I suggest we start swapping digital signatures more often, maybe twice a week. Forward Gurgunitsa is keypad code for the back door, 091772. I'll expect the pickup by 10 a.m. Say happy birthday to Kay for me. Hopefully, I'll be back in VA for the next one. I wonder what VA is. Virginia? You got maps. You got this thing. In case you guys want to read, just keep pausing it. The certain isn't very robust language. She's sharp but timid. Her methods. Again, pause if you want to read it. A real cowboy. A good example of the old guard at Langley. And Gurkunitsa. No notes on this character. Nice, I suppose. And yeah, from this point onwards, the game is going to get a little more tricky. Just a little, not too much. And I hope there's no one out there who's looking right at us. Actually, there is someone right there. Well, let's see if they can see us. Or can they? Gurgunitsa's dead truck. Well, they can't. So it's fine, I guess. And here is a rating that we need to grab. Not there, sir. Not there.
Not there, come on, what the fuck?
Sorry, I know I shouldn't be doing that, but, I mean, come on, you need to grab this, yeah, exactly. I'm not taking fall damage, unnecessarily, unless I have to.
Fisher, I'm rescinding my street level restriction. We've been monitoring the Tbilisi police radio. These cops are as crooked as a Virginia fence. They're not going to want any more international attention than we do. Every road is open to you. Do what you gotta do to find those missing spooks.
Awesome. Now we'll be able to see just how clunky this game gets. Yeah, we need to unlock this. And we just want to stick to this wall here.
What do you think you're doing? Prison cells don't come cheap these days.
The real estate is closer to your rent in the morgue.
Slabs are going for cheap.
Yeah, I think we could set you up with a slab real easy.
I've done nothing. Please. Nothing? How about drunk and disorderly? Assaulting a police officer? Slandering the badge?
You said we're associated with criminals.
Then arrest me. I must sleep. Weren't you listening?
The rent's gone up in jail.
You want to die tonight? That's free. You want to sleep tonight? It'll cost you 100 lari.
Oh, please. I don't. Now what are we going to do with him?
Check his pockets. I'll radio HQ.
Sure.
Unit 3 to dispatch. We have a 1053.
Yet apparently.
Sure. Unit 3 to dispatch. We have a 1053. Possible assault. Can you send an ambulance?
Copy that, Unit 3, but we're dealing with a warehouse fire, so expect delay.
Roger that, dispatch.
So this is what I mean when I say that this game is super clunky.
Unit 3 out. Assault? Something we can pin on Costa.
Seriously? Yeah, I'm not even gonna bother with that. You can do what you want to. So when you drop down in this game, you want to hit the C button, like as you're dropping down, just so that you know. Let's hope this guy can see us anymore. And now that that's done, we can just stick to the shadows here. No. Another one of the bad things about this game is, I probably shouldn't have quick saved there, but oh well, whatever works, I guess. So one of the bad things about this game is, when enemies get too close to you, you don't really need to be in the shadows for them not to notice you. What am I saying? Basically what I'm trying to say is, if you're in the shadows, it does not matter whether you're in the shadows or not. If the enemies get too close to you, they will notice you. That is in stark contrast to the more recent games. Not the more recent games, rather the highest echelon of stealth game ever created. Chaos Theory, that is. In that game, if the enemies get to... Even if you're right in front of the enemy and it's just too dark for them to see, they will not be able to see you. Let's hope I'm not going to boss into somebody here. Because there is, I think, somebody that comes through here. For the time being, I'm in the shadows, so it doesn't really matter much. And let's hope that it stays that way. I'm just going to create a save file, so that I don't have to do it again. Save to. Yeah. So right here we have this guy is looking at us. You don't want him looking at us. And we'll get to that. I'm just gonna save the game here and make a run for it, hoping that nobody sees me. Yeah, he isn't there anymore. That's good. So, guy basically got stuck there. Oh, I never noticed this. Nice. I got more bullets, which I'm not gonna use. Don't you just love when a game does that? Yeah, and that's the sound that we want to hear. So basically, the guy was standing there because, well, he saw us going into this place. And that is something which you don't want. So see, right now, this place is all clear. We can practically proceed. I'm just going to try it once. And I'm immediately going into the shadows here. Yeah, because right over there, there are guards, which we do not want to attract. As soon as this guy passes by... Now, another thing about this game is how the stealth level indicator, the lighting level indicator works. It works in absolute levels. There's no, you know, separation of how well they can see you, how well they cannot see you. Like for example, I can be at the very edge of this first notch that I'm on, and these guys will not be able to see. So where's this guy again? You know what? I'm just gonna try making run for it. I guess I saved it afterwards. So yeah, this time I'm going to save the game and save win. Yeah, boy. Good job. And I'm going to try and see where this road takes us. Let's hope it doesn't take us anywhere we're not supposed to go. And I'm just going to keep sticking to the side. Oh boy. And yeah, we just want to stick to this side because right over there, there's a guy. He carries a satchel. We do not need that satchel. It will just give us more relevant information. However, we need to knock him out to get that satchel. And that is a bad thing. So no, you do not knock out strangers. And if you actually wear these... Yeah, and actually, if you actually wear these night vision goggles, you can see that there's another guy over there. Who's pretty much expecting you. So you just want to go from shadow to shadow, not expose yourself, because the thing about these motherfuckers is they'll know. Might as well save here, because this is as safe a spot as it gets. That guy's gonna go over, we cannot proceed further. What we can do is wait for this guy to go away, and then we can go where we want to. And I believe there's also a guy above us, although I don't really know how that works. And this guy's going to take, it's just going to basically keep pausing every now and then. And I believe the guy on the other end, let me show you. So, if I try to go ahead and maneuver into the station right now, the guy on the other end will see us. Of course, I'll be reloading again. See, there are two people here. So yeah, you just want to wait until these guys pass by, and then you may proceed. Hopefully. Let me just stick to the walls here, just in case, you know, they feel inclined to see me. Hush now. Luckily for us, that guy on the other end, he does not stop to look back, and that is practically what we want. This guy, he turns around and he will catch a glimpse of us. We do not want that, that is bad for us. Come, let us keep moving forwards. And here is where we want to go. We just want to stick to this wall. That other guy's patrol route is long. And let's see if this works now. There shouldn't be anybody.
Some kind of foreign soldier around.
This time I'm gonna save when I get up there, so that I don't have to do this shit again. At the very least. Fuck my English.
What is that?
I have got no idea how he sees me, but he does, and well, congratulations to him for that. I'm just gonna quick save here. And we're just gonna sit here all nice and easy. And hope that he doesn't turn back. Because if he does, we're fucked.
Oh my god!
That guy up there, apparently. Fuck, we've got to reload now. So this is what I meant when I said that this game is clunky as hell. There are a lot of times when these people will see you, even though there's literally nobody there. Do I want to stay crouched? It might be a better option for the time being. Yeah. Much better.
Must have been that.
Good job. You realized that all on your own. Yeah, I'm just gonna create a separate spear save here. And I'm gonna save under save too. Yes, please. I like to keep alternating between saves, not creating too many save files for whatever reason. So this guy's a...
Oh my god!
Come out wherever you are!
Okay, let's try this then. If we can do that.
Who is that?
Yeah, that's where you want him to go. So that he can actually search in that area. And you want to silently just go behind this guy. Fine. I didn't want to hit that particular target, but well, it worked out in the end anyway. Yeah, I would rather do a quick save right here. And what we need to go is that distance right there. Yeah, we want to climb this place. And we want to climb here and go here. And quickly just go over. Well, we didn't need to do that then. And here we are at the final leg of the level. The first level is horrible. I'll just go ahead and say the first level is horrible. There's nothing else that you can do about it. I'm just gonna save the save too. And if you're playing this game, I mean, unless you've literally got every single route memorized, it is better that you keep saving. Otherwise, it's going to prove a nightmare for you. And there's nothing down there. So this is basically the police station that we need to enter. And here is a note. We want to go to the mission information and go to notes, and this is the code for this door, 5929. That being said, let me just do a quick save here and I'll be back. And I'm back. So yeah, that was a rash move, but alright, fine. So we basically want to wait here until this card comes back, or we can just like do a wall split. Let me just go ahead and try to do that.
Who in the hell are you supposed to be?
Yeah, let's rush. And what we want to do right here is just keep going forward. We will not be collecting the data from this guy right now, because we do not want him alerted to us. And right now is when you want to come over to this side. This is where our objective lies anyway, in the door back there. And let me just show you once what I was talking about. Just remain crouched here, and I don't know what that guy's doing, but he's doing something. And as you can see right here, there's a guy sitting right there. That doesn't exactly bode well for us. So where we want to go is in here. Just quickly come here and stick to this side. I'm just doing a quick save here. I'm also going to be switching over to my pistol. I'm just going to take this piece of data nonetheless. And quickly, we're going to enter behind this curtain here. And there's a camera. We'll need the pistol to shoot out the camera. I wonder where the camera is though. Because I can't see it right. Oh yeah, right there. And that's it. And at least this part of the game is solved. We need not go any further for this. Blaustein and Madrigal or whatever their names are right here.
I've got agents Blaustein and Madison.
Rest in peace. Somebody cut out their subdermals.
Where do we go from here?
We follow the subdermals if we can.
There's a security camera here.
Good thinking. We'll track the subdermals from the video archives. The station's surveillance room is on the top floor.
Nice. Now let me just quick save the game here and take the time to read this database, this data stick that I got from them. Dr. Slava Klonipotze to Sergeant Ramaz Lotkipanitze. Damn, these names are Russian. Mock security cameras. Sergeant, while I appreciate your newfound zeal in securing the station, I wonder at the need for a surveillance camera in the morgue. In my 40 years as a medical examiner, I have never once seen a cadaver commit a crime. I'm certain that there are no other places in this very building where security cameras might do a much better job of spotting criminals. And not speaking of the holding cells either. Why, just last week I attacked some poor soul whose skull had been caved in by an object distinctly similar to patterns issued by our officers. Had there been security cameras in the research lab instead of the morgue itself, we might have caught the party responsible for destroying the evidence in that case. MEPG. Did I autosave? Let's just autosave again. And here's where things get tricky. You want this guy coming over to this side. Otherwise, you're going to end up in trouble, basically, is what I'm trying to say. Come on. Thank you. And with that, I think we're done. I don't think we had something to check in there. I did the first time just out of curiosity because I love, I just like exploring things whenever I can. And yeah, that. So again over here, I doubt there are any threats right now. What we want to do is go upstairs. Right up into the surveillance room actually, and unfortunately, for the most part in these games, ghosting is not possible. Let this guy enter a conversation with him.
I'd like to talk to your superior.
Perhaps I can help you, sir.
By fetching your superior.
I'm all there is. How can I help you?
I'd like to register a complaint.
Then you'll have to ask at the desk to your right.
Very well.
May I help you?
You're the same cop.
Yes, but this is the public relations desk.
Fine. I would like to register a complaint.
Of course, you think I see something.
Okay, let's just grab that dialogue first.
If you could just have a seat until somebody's ready to help you.
You've got to be kidding me.
I could easily have you arrested, sir.
Hold up. What's that?
Nothing at all. Mind your own business. Come on. You didn't just come all the way over here. My God. Yeah, that's right. Go on, mind your own business. Come on. Snooping around will do you no good. Leave that to me. To the professionals. What am I walking? Oh, I'm walking into a wall right here. So that's the way up, and yeah. So that is how you successfully clear that part out. There are no secondary objectives to this game, so you can sort of rest assured while doing whatever you want to. There are two guys working here, and where we need to go is the second door on the right over there. The first time around, I went through every single computer and every single doorway there was. I even tried to climb this pipe quite desperately, and I ended up, you know, getting discovered every single time. The thing is, you don't really need to get into all of those. computers. You can do without getting into those computers as well. I think there's something about these two rooms, their interrogation rooms. This one is the interrogation room, that one's the observation room. And this is the surveillance room, where we need to go. So, right now, I'm just gonna go ahead and check. Oh, fuck. I meant to check. Sorry. So yeah, as you can see, there's already a guy in here. He's surveilling stuff, as is the job of a surveillance person. And unfortunately, as I was saying, ghosting is a very rare thing in this game. You are going to have to knock out a lot of people, and you're going to have to put them in the shadows. So yeah, if you didn't knock this guy out, there are ways to do it. There are ways to, like, finish the game without knocking people out, but yeah, this game is, you're not meant to do that in the game, is basically what I'm trying to say. Alright, a new data sick. I'm just going to read that out. Sergeant Ramaz, yeah. Reply, Givi, or Givi, I don't know. Gizo, or Gizo. I don't trust Kavsadze. I don't care who he's related to. I don't want him within throwing distance of our house. I wonder who that is. If you actually knock out all the guards here like you're supposed to in this original version of Splinter Cell, then you will get a lot of things.
Great work, Fisher. We're scanning the videotapes now.
There, that's our guy. We got him red-handed.
Can you run his face through Echelon?
Already on it. Hey, check it out. A license plate. 84KP214.
Fantastic. Fisher, we got what we need. Rendezvous with Wilkes, your work here is done. We'll get back to you once we've sifted this intel.
Good, good, good. That guy's in the shadows, as we wanted. He's not going to be bothering us anymore. And I'm just going to quick save here, because we'll need it, trust me. As you saw, there is no way of going through the bottom door there without disturbing anyone. The first level isn't particularly complex. It's just very clunky. Too clunky. And the exfil, you have to attract some attention there. I don't know why they designed it to be that way, but you have to attract attention there. There's practically no other way around it. So right now we're just going to go over to this end, and let me try being stealthy. I know I cannot, for the extraction just is that way. I mean, there are a few lights here, but you cannot shoot them out either. So, and for some reason this door just glows, keeps glowing. Practically there is no way for a safe extraction. Unless short of, you know, unless you like take this guy out somehow. I'm just going to click save here and let's try going out. And yay, we attracted no attention. The Tbilisi Police Precinct. Tbilisi, Georgia, October 16, 2004, 22:29 hours. That sort of took a long time, didn't it? The bodies of agents Blaustein and Madison were located in the morgue of a Tbilisi police precinct. Before being sent to Georgia, the agents had been outfitted with subdermal tracking implants. These implants were removed from the corpses and taken to the Georgian Ministry of Defense by a man named Vyacheslav Grinko. So basically, as the plot unravels, that's what I'm trying to, you know, follow the plot, because the first time, initially when I played these games, you basically have to focus a little bit on the details and wonder about the whys of why you're doing these things. But the first time I followed the plot, I couldn't really understand what was going on. I just played through the games because, hey, levels, stealth action. But yeah, so as far as the plot is unfolding thus far, we have discovered, you know, coup d'etat happened, and our agents in the field in that location, well, they just suddenly disappeared. We got information regarding the fact that the CIA already knew that their agents had, agents had disappeared, but they refused to share that with the NSA, and now our focus slowly turns towards, you guess, the CIA, and we also get information about Russia's Grimko. So yeah, so that's it for today. I shall see you guys later, another time, I don't really know when, in the next video, of course. And until then, take care, fellow Earthlings. Farewell. See you later.